Candice Bergen, Charlie McCarthy's sister, daughter of Edgar Bergen. I mean, she was a legend before she was 10 years old. She has written a rather remarkable book about her life with Edgar and Charlie and her mother, who was once a showgirl. But she had some stormy times with Edgar Bergen. I asked her what he would think of her today.
Oh, I think today he would be immensely relieved, first of all, that that my life seems to have found not only a stability, but that in my marriage I have found such peace and such happiness. I think that's what he wanted for me above everything, and I think he saw me flailing around looking for that and not quite knowing how to go about it, and that doesn't come easily either.
Right.
And I've grown up a lot since my father died, and I suppose his death was a large factor in that.
Yeah. Well, you know, it's interesting. You talk about the fact that no one in your family, all growing up, ever said, "I love you," to anybody. Your mother tried to tell him that, and he kind of put her down, said, "We don't talk about things like that."
My father was a very affectionate, very loving man, but came from Swedish parents and a very stoical Midwestern Scandinavian background. But it in no way reflected on the love that he felt for his family. It was just that we were not accustomed to articulating those feelings, and I only talked about it in the book because it has a bearing on how I handled my own feelings.
I've always heard, or here again we read, I've always heard that you hated to hear talk about being Charlie McCarthy's sister and all that, and yet the book's called Knockwood, there's a title called Charlie's Sister. I guess for all the hoopla and the hype, it was the way you grew up, wasn't it? You were kind of
a lot of that hype is just hype. I didn't hate to be called Charlie McCarthy's sister, although I suppose, you know, there are labels that you'd rather live by. But there is an irony to that, as there is just to the mere existence that my father chose to be a ventriloquist. I mean, that choice for a man who's uncomfortable with expressing feelings is no accident, but it's a pretty interesting one.
Right.
And now, of course, I'm totally enamored of having been Charlie's sister, and you know, I wanted to have as much of that in the book as possible because I find the complexity of it and the humor of it and the nostalgia of it fascinating.
Now, I would imagine that that amateur psychologists would read what I think is a lovely passage and endearing of in the mornings, you sitting on your father's left knee and Charlie on the right, or vice versa, and him both moving your neck and you as a kid moving yours and Charlie moving his. I think somebody would say, aha, he was trying to manipulate Candy just like he did Charlie. You think there's any truth
to that? No, absolutely not. You know, that was for a long time before he was married. My father really, and this I discovered in doing research in the clippings, he would have interviews with journalists, and he was almost totally tongue-tied unless he had Charlie with him.
Yeah.
And then the interview took on steam and animated, and he became quite garrulous because Charlie was taking over, and Charlie was handling all the questions and fielding them adroitly. And I think that this was a man whose genius was expressing various characters through these devices, and it was his way of playing with his daughter. It was his way of having fun with me.
Oh,
it was his way of, you know, it would be like playing with dolls, except that, you know, to a little girl, this was some kind of doll.
Your recounting of your growing up is truly, God, I hate to use such a terrible cliche, but fairy tale. I mean, Walt Disney was Uncle Walt in your backyard and the parties and everything.
It was a fairy tale, and I very much see the book as a fairy tale. With, you know, some dark edges, but those are only dark edges that I think Hollywood has. They're not about my childhood.
Right.
And I see my childhood as being enchanted.
I kind of felt reading that you got tired and you resented always being observed as being icy and cool and the aloof kind of woman. Did you resent? And you were always referred to that way.
I was, yes.
Maybe, or
still
are you?
Maybe.
Well, are you? Are you that way, really? I don't know.
Well, you know, in spite of the book, which is a strange contradiction, I am fairly private.
Sure.
And quite like my father, I'm also remote with people that I don't know or people that I'm not comfortable with. But I'm also very bawdy and love to laugh, but not with people that...
Do you think you're beautiful?
I I don't. There are some times when, well, I really never understood what all the fuss was about. There are times when, you know, I pull things together and I think, oh, gee, I look like Candice Bergen. But but basically it's like, what are they making such a big deal about? So I don't know. I'm always sort of waiting for people to say, what were we making such a big deal about?